Shuddering, my hollow skeletal structure pulled taut against the buffeting walls of vicious gales. At the breaking point between my being and my environment, I burst at last into the swiftly moving sunset once again. My velocity nearly tripling as I rocketed exultantly into the gently drifting dance of the beatific atmosphere. My elation, however, was short-lived. Once again, I was soon losing ground to the ever-approaching night. I strained my avian body to its limit, taking advantage of any breeze my feathers could catch. Then came salvation. An updraft swept through the trees along the river, and telltale shadows flowing through the leaf patterns told me where to expect it. I caught the gust, but before I could rejoice, a brutal projectile from below tore me from the heavens. It maimed my right wing, and I screamed in rage at the immensity of my vain efforts. Defeated and destroyed by a heartless beast that knew nothing of my struggle, I surrendered into the torrential winds of the night. I tumbled madly, yet I could distinguish every blackened blade of grass as the banks of the river spun toward me. It was upon impact that I jerked awake. The night was replaced by the dimly lit interior of the limousine. General Killjoy was leaning over me, jabbing me in the arm with his remote control. His face was contorted into a dutiful scowl, a grimace of curious disgust, as if he were poking a dead animal with the tip of his rifle. The Book o' Billy Doos. Rose Hips. What do you mean when you say until death becomes irrelevant? Explain yourself. Do you really think death is irrelevant, or do you dismiss it as such because you fear it?